get to mathematical questions. Practically, conjugate gradient requires accurate one-dimensional optimization in order to achieve this conjugate orthogonality. And BFGS doesn't require so accurate behavior. And it stores like more information, it keeps memory of what was happening before and built in so clever ways that it's self-correcting.
Yes, and
that's why it's better, it may be in practice better than conjugate gradient for non-linear functions. Yes.
But LFBFGS does not remember everything, and I started to read an article, but I didn't completely understand it, that says that the fact that it doesn't store the previous steps is actually an advantage because it ignores unnecessary steps. And I don't understand why is it so? I don't know why is it so good.
Just a second. LBFGS, it stores increments of x, but not increments of gradients, but some intermediate vectors which are used in computing of the matrix. It's a product of our model of inverse Hessian on previous differences of gradients. And usually it stores such vectors for last, for example, 10 iterations. So what is your question?
No, just like, what's the mathematical proof that it converges? What's the rate of why the rate of
convergence? Why?
Like, how was it developed? What is the intuition behind it? Like, we just got a formula.
Did you try to read the Nocidal and Wright book?
No, I tried to read a different book.
Nocidal, I think he's an author of LBFGS.
Oh.
He should explain it well. So, Nocidal and Wright is a good reference to read, and it's, I think it's all available.
Okay.
If no general questions, as usual, we start free discussion. Who wants to stay here?